Thank you, Jeremy. Good evening.
Good evening.
It's great to welcome you to our candlelight services, lessons, and carols tonight here at First Presbyterian Church. We do have folks joining us virtually. We extend a welcome to them, and hopefully they'll be able to extend their greetings back and forth virtually while we're greeting one another. Let's please stand and introduce ourselves to one another in Christ's love. Many of you made your way into the sanctuary tonight through the narthex, and if you did, you saw a huge pile of blankets there. I do want to just mention to you where those came from. Barbara's School for the Dance, one of the local dance centers, for a number of years has been donating blankets to our church that we share at our Saturday soup kitchen and also during the weekday when we distribute lunches. The dancers from Barbara's started over a decade ago when one of our young women in the church, Paige Butts, was a student, and she started taking up a collection of blankets. Well, they've continued that tradition, and this past week, the dancers themselves came with their families, and they left 213 blankets for that ministry. So we thank them so much for that. You know, on these cold days when people come by the church, if it seems like they'll be in a place where they do not have heat, we offer them a blanket. At the soup kitchen, there will be one or two events this winter where the 100 people who come to the soup kitchen, many of them will not have a good place to go for the night. And so those 200 blankets are going to help us spread warmth to so many folks. The girls from Barbara's also come out every February, and that's kind of fun. My wife, who is a teacher, and I are the head cooks at that time. And so the challenge is to have a menu that 25 eager 4-year-old to 12th graders can cook together in the kitchen. So we always do a lot of prep and work on that, but it's wonderful because they really do like serving in the community. So we thank them for what they've donated there, and we're really excited about that opportunity. We're going to be taking what's called a retiring offering when you leave tonight. We will not pass a plate. And if you would like to make a donation, you'll see a medical bag in the narthex back there. You probably walked by it coming in and out. That medical bag is symbolic. The money that we take up tonight does not stay here at the church. It goes out to different ministries, 4 different medical missions. One is one that we work with every other year when we're in Honduras. We send 25% of that down to the clinic down in Honduras. And then we've selected through Medical Benevolence Foundation 3 other missions. You'll see those noted in the bulletin. So if you would like to make a donation tonight, just drop something in that medical bag. We will then divide that into 4 and send that off to those missions. And so we thank you for your support of that. I want to thank our musicians tonight. They have spent a lot of time preparing, and they've come out to be worship leaders tonight. So what we're going to do since before the service, last service I didn't let them applaud because it would have broken. We haven't really started the flow yet, so let's thank our musicians for all their work. Thank you so much. This service is lessons and carols, and so there are different readers from the congregation reading the story that we long to hear, and then the carols, the music, just take that story and implant it in our hearts and our souls. So great to have you all with us tonight for this service of lessons and carols. Let us now prepare our hearts to worship God. Thank you.
Please join with me in the call to worship printed in your bulletin this evening. But to you, O Bethlehem, who are one of the clans of Judah, from you shall come forth for me one who is to rule in Israel, who is from old, from ancient days.
Our ancestors waited eagerly to celebrate the birth of the Holy Child of Bethlehem.
Therefore, he shall give them up until the time when she who is in labor has brought forth. Then the rest of his kindred shall return to the people of Israel.
God's people waited faithfully until the good news of the birth was a reality.
And he shall stand and feed his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God, and they shall live secure. For now he shall be great to the ends of the earth.
Tonight we join God's people around the world, celebrating that Christ the Savior is born.
Let's continue in that celebration as we stand to sing our first hymn, O Come All Ye Faithful. Please stand as you're comfortable.
Thank you.
we join our hearts together in prayer this evening, I will leave a silence throughout our prayer that will conclude with this closing bidding. Lord, in your mercy, we will all respond with, Lord, hear our prayers. Will you join with me as we pray this evening? Glory to you, O God, for the good news of great joy that you give to all the people. Thank you for Jesus Christ, the Messiah, who lived among us and now reigns on high. Thank you for his light that shines in the darkness. With the angels, we sing praise to you, celebrating your glory in all the earth, in the Son given to us, and in your promised salvation. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayers. Gathered as a community on this Christmas Eve, whether virtually or in the sanctuary, we pray for your church in every place and a reiteration that we may make known to others what has been told to us about this child. Help us to bear Christ's light in every place of need. Draw near to those who spend this night apart from their community, travelers and those far from home, people who live alone, one who waits in a hospital room, one who sits in a prison cell, those who work deep into the night, those protecting and serving, one estranged from family or friends. We pray for comfort for those who are poor or vulnerable, the child at risk, the homeless on the streets, the family that is hungry, and those contending with prejudice and scorn. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayers. O babe of Bethlehem, may the joy we feel this night reflect our blessed hope in your birth. We give thanks that Christ continues to call us to follow him and gives us the ministry of reconciliation to fulfill in his name. At this glorious time of his birth, help us to reach out to those who feel no joy, for whom thanksgiving is difficult because darkness enfolds them. Let us give to them the beacon of light that will lead them to your gift of new life. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayers. May our little light shine in the shades of the night. Hold those we love and all of the world in your tender and sure hands, as a mother holds her newborn child. Let your face shine upon us with peace. Gather up the past, the present, and the future into your eternity, where all is reconciled and you are all in all. In the name of him who was born this night, Jesus Emmanuel, who is the Christ the Lord, and taught his disciples to pray together, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Thank you.
Let us now proclaim the wondrous birth and lessons and carols, the lighting of the first Advent candle, the prophets foretold. Let us join in hymn 123.
Isaiah chapter 9, verses 2, 6, and 7. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. They lived in a land of shadows, but now light is shining on them. A child is born to us, a son is given to us, and he will be our ruler. He will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Eternal Father, Prince of Peace. His royal power will continue to grow. His kingdom will always be at peace. He will rule as King David's successor, basing his power on right and justice from now until the end of time. The Lord Almighty is determined to do all this.
I will be reading from Isaiah chapter 11, verses 1 and 2 and 6 through 9. The royal line of David is like a tree that has been cut down, but just as new branches sprout from a stump, so a new king will arise from among David's descendants. The Spirit of the Lord will give him wisdom and the knowledge and skill to rule his people. He will know the Lord's will and have reverence for him. Wolves and sheep will live together in peace, and leopards will lie down with young goats. Calves and lion cubs will feed together, and little children will take care of them. Cows and bears will eat together, and their calves and cubs will lie down in peace. Lions will eat straw as cattle do. Even a baby will not be harmed if it plays near a poisonous snake. On Zion, God's holy hill, there will be nothing harmful or evil. The land will be as full of knowledge of the Lord as the seas are full of water.
The lighting of the second Advent candle. Mary will have a son.
Mm-hmm. reading from Luke 1, 26 through 38. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God. And now your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son. And this is the sixth month for her who was said to be barren, for nothing will be impossible with God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her.
Thank you.
the lighting of the third Advent candle, a great joy to all the people. As we join together in singing, Hark the Herald Angels Sing, I would invite the children who are present to join us down front for our time with younger disciples. Thank you all for coming down front. We have a scripture that I'm going to read tonight, but we're going to look at this scripture in little pieces and see if you can't tell me where the characters are in that nativity set. Okay? So listen. In Luke's gospel, it said, "In those days, Caesar Augustus declared that everyone throughout the whole empire should be enrolled in the tax lists. The first enrollment occurred when Quirinius was governor of Syria. Everybody had to go to their own city to be enrolled. A man named Joseph belonged to David's house and family line, and he went up from a city called Nazareth in Galilee to David's city called Bethlehem in Judea. He went to be enrolled together with Mary, who was promised to him in marriage, and she was pregnant." So, if we look at that thing here, can any of you, and we can come close because there's just a couple of us, can you point out Joseph in that one to me? This guy Joseph? Or maybe we'll look for Mary. Is that easier? Where's Mary? There she is. So next to her is Joseph, and he's holding a stick, a walking stick, that almost looks like a shepherd's crook. Now, it says that while they were there, Mary had her baby. She gave birth to her firstborn, and she wrapped him snugly in bands of cloth and put him in a manger because there was no place for them in a guest room. So as you're looking at that there, does this look like a house? What does it look like?
Stable.
Looks like a stable, doesn't it? And what are the hints that it's a stable?
Donkeys and animals.
Okay, good hints. Do you have donkeys in your house? Do you let cows come into the house? No.
No, but there's a
barn dominiums.
No, there's a barn like in the end of my neighborhood.
Okay, barn near the end of your neighborhood, but for the three of us talking right now.
Yeah, no.
Yeah, cows, donkeys, they're outside animals in the stable. Well, there they are. And see this baby Jesus? Does that look like a baby bed to you that he's laying on?
No, that looks like hay.
It looks like hay because that's what it's supposed to be.
Oh.
So they placed the baby Jesus in the same place that this cow would eat from every day.
That is unsanitary.
Well, but the story goes on. Nearby, there were shepherds. Can you all find a shepherd for me? Point to a shepherd, or two, or three. How do you know they're shepherds? Well, there's two, actually. Okay, what's this guy got on his shoulders?
Is that a sheep?
A sheep, yep. So he's picked up the sheep to carry it back to the flock.
I couldn't tell if that was a sheep.
And this one here is nudging the sheep forward. So it said there were shepherds, and they were working in the fields, and, now find this for me, an angel appeared to them. Do you see an angel anywhere? How do you know?
Because it got the big wings.
Big wings. That's a good sign that it's probably an angel. And it says that the angel said, "Don't be afraid. I bring you good news for everybody. In David's city, Christ the Lord is born, and this is how you'll know him. You will find a babe wrapped snugly and lying in a manger." And it said, suddenly with the angel. And this is a nativity set that I showed at church this morning. It was a gift to the church this year. This is half of it.
Half?
Half of it.
Then how big is it?
Well, there are about 15 more characters that go with it. See that angel over there? She's one of nine. I left the other eight downstairs for tonight, but it says, suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, okay, glory to God, because the Savior has been born. Then it says that the shepherds, when the angels went away, they said, let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that's happened. Let's see if what the Lord said to us is true. And they went quickly, and what did they find? Mary and Joseph.
And a baby.
Perfect. And a baby lying in a manger. And they told them what the angels had told them, and everybody was amazed. And Mary kept those things in her heart.
He's the three kings?
Yep, those are the three kings. And let me give you here. Go down just a little bit so people behind us can see. These are the three kings. We looked at them this morning. We're going to sing. Oh, you went too far. But these three kings, we're going to hear about them in a few minutes. And this morning, I gave a hint that they rode here on something special. So stand up again real quick. What did they ride on?
Elephant.
Anybody see a donkey?
Elephant
and a donkey?
Camel.
I mean donkey. Camel, elephant.
Elephant.
That's how they made the trip. But we're going to sing about them in a minute. So this is the story that Luke tells us about a baby whose birth was announced by angels, who was told to shepherds, and they all came to see. And you're right. And next we would have this story. And we're going to sing about those in a few minutes. But there's a song that we want to sing. Now, at the early service, there were 30 kids here, so they didn't mind singing together. I'm not going to make you all do a duet, but we're going to ask the congregation to join us away in a manger. I think most of them probably know the first verse. Do you all know the first verse of that from memory? They're going to sing with us.
No.
Okay, well, I think I remember it. So let's all join together. There's Mr. Jeremy over there. Okay, Mr. Jeremy, we're going to do three verses of Away in a Manger. From memory for all of us, you all have the last two verses. Thank you. story that we tell is about a baby that was placed in a manger, about Mary and Joseph who heard God speak to them and followed what God said. And that's how the whole story starts. Like I said, then we get shepherds and angels and wise men and all these folks who join together. So this is our nativity at the church. Like I said, it was a gift this year to the church. And the first part was 21 pieces, and ours has about another 15 that go with it. And so we have it out today so we can see it. I have some nativities at home, but they aren't nearly this big or this many pieces. So what's our count to?
19.
Okay. 16. Okay. Somewhere in there. But like I said, I shorted us a couple angels. They'll come up at another time. Or actually, all these will go down to the office where there's a beautiful display case for them. But I want you to see that. But to remember that, I want to give you all something. This year when we went to Honduras, we bought little nativities to bring back for this day. And so these, they don't have elephants and they don't have shepherds.
Oh,
but they all have a Mary, a Joseph, and a little teeny baby. So, yeah, pick one out that you like. And then you've got a little sister, right? Would you pick one out for her? Perfect. Okay? And let's have a prayer together. God, help us to know the story so we can tell the story. And we thank you that right now we are celebrating that Christ the Savior was born for us. We thank you for that and ask you to guide us and direct us in Christ's name. Amen. Now we've got a little bit more in the worship service today. So if you want, there are some activities in here you might enjoy back at your seat. And there's a cool sticker collection there of a nativity. So I'll give you those. Thank you for coming and thanks for helping us with the story.
Stars are brightly shining. It is the night of the dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining till he appeared on the surface.
the lighting of the fourth Advent candle. Let us come and worship.
A reading from Matthew 2, 1 through 12. In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem asking, "Where is the child who is born King of the Jews? For we observed his star at its rising and have come to pay him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all Jerusalem with him. And calling together all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for so it has been written by the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people, Israel.'" Then Herod secretly called for the wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found him, bring me word, so that I may also go and pay him homage." When they had heard the king, they set out, and there ahead of them went the star that they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chests, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they left for their own country by another road.
The lighting of the Christ candle, the light of the world.
A reading from John chapter 1, verses 1 through 14. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world has came into being through him, yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood or of the will of the flesh or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth.
Passing the light of peace. The light shines in the darkness, John says, and the darkness has not overcome it.
Thank you.
We as a congregation gather each Lord's Day, usually in the morning, for worship. And a couple of times a year, we gather as a congregation in the sanctuary for a special worship service. There are two nights that I long to see every year. One is Ash Wednesday, when I stand up front after the marking with ashes and I look out, and on your faces I see crosses showing that you are Christians and are going out into the world. The other is tonight, when this sanctuary is lighted only by the light from the Christ window, the Christmas trees, and your candles. We have heard the good news that a Savior has come. We have heard of people who came to worship him. And we join the angels and all those before us in proclaiming that he is our Savior. And to show that what John said is true, the light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it, let us lift the light of Christ. We come into God's house because we long to hear the good news. We go out into the world because it longs to hear the good news too. So friends, grace, mercy, and peace from God the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with all of you, and join the angels and proclaim our Savior has been born. Amen.